The Ducks' last visit to L.A. was just 19 miles right from here, hosted in one of the most historic venues. Oregon displayed a flashy offensive attack and emerged victorious in the 98th Rose Bowl game. A well-deserved historic win for Chip Kelly and company in Pasadena's granddaddy of them all.
Hey, Duck fans. Kurt here with another Fish Duck Vlog. Well, the Olympics are officially underway. They launched with a giant Voldemort fighting a bunch of Mary Poppins's Mary Poppins, plural of Mary Poppins, I'm not sure. Olympic ceremonies get weirder every time. I don't know what to say about that. There are 10 Oregon Ducks competing at the games this time, though, all in track and field related events. The track events haven't really started yet, but they will very soon. It is 13 days until the first Oregon event of the 2012-2013 year. That's when Oregon volleyball has their green-yellow exhibition. That's taking place August 11th at 7 p.m. at Matt Knight Arena. All focus, though, is on the start of football season. It is coming, we promise. It's about a month away right now, and only about a week or so before fall camp opens. That's when freshmen are reporting to camp, and once again, all recruits qualified and will be arriving for practice and classes. That's wonderful news. That's become a trend under Chip Kelly, something that didn't always happen under Bilotti. So that's a terrific job by Oregon coaches in not just getting top-notch athletes to come to Oregon, but to make sure that they qualify as well as students. Oregon coaches are doing things the right way. Unfortunately, it's one of those storylines that really doesn't get played out in the media very much. You know, they love a good scandal or any rumor. And speaking of rumors, the Twitter sphere has been exploding with rumors all about Chip Kelly's hot tub.
Are you excited to have a hot tub?
I don't have a hot tub.
Not in your office, but the coaches have a hot tub, right? Or is that not?
There's a wet area in the locker room between the coaches and the players. There's a wet area in the Casanova Center. I think there's a hot tub in every, or whirlpool, whatever you want to call it, in every college football facility in the country. So I don't understand the big controversy.
I don't think it's a controversy.
Well, you asked the question, so you must do.
It was a controversy. I just want to know if you're excited to be able to watch film in a hot tub.
We don't have film in a hot tub.
Are you going to in 2 years?
No. This is the biggest overblown story I've ever heard in my life.
Tub. You know, there's a couple tubs that will be in the building. It's not private for Chip Kelly to watch game film, so that was a ridiculous story. But Pac-12 Media Day was earlier this week. Chip Kelly, Kenyon Barner, and Michael Clay were on hand to answer questions for TV and radio interviews and media personnel. Now, these Media Day things, it's overall kind of uneventful. It's not really so much what's said. It's more so important of what the day represents, that it is the official start of the football season. It is the moment when we can pinpoint, look, it's happening, okay? Practice is going to start soon. The coaches are being interviewed. Everyone is talking football right now. It's coming. So we're only about 2 weeks away now from the launch of the Pac-12 network. And if you want to watch our Ducks on TV, you're going to need it, because not all the games are going to be on national TV. The first one, Arkansas State, will be on ESPN. After that, the next couple games, Pac-12 network. So you got to make sure that you have it. They also put out a really cool video earlier this week that was a recap of Oregon's Rose Bowl victory over Wisconsin back in January. Now, if you missed that, you can find it posted in the Fish Duck Forum, and it is definitely worth a look, hosted by Ronnie Lott. So check with your provider to make sure that they will be carrying it. Currently, there are no deals in place with any satellite providers in the Pac-12 network. So if you've got a dish, in a couple weeks' time, you may have to tear that down in favor of whichever cable provider is in your area that does provide Pac-12 network. Finally, there are a couple events coming up next week that Duck fans should definitely check out. If you remember the music video O-Time from last year, Exile and Jared Sawyer are back this year with a new music video that they will be premiering very soon. It'll be the soundtrack of all of your tailgate parties. I've heard it. It's awesome. To unveil the new video, they are having a couple premiere parties that if you're in Oregon, you should definitely attend. First, on Thursday, August 2nd at On Deck Sports Bar and Grill in Portland at 7 p.m. They'll be premiering the video. They'll also have a live performance and some very special guests. Many current and former Oregon Ducks players should be there. And for folks in Eugene, they'll be doing the exact same thing Saturday, August 4th at 6th Street Grill in Eugene, starting around 6 p.m. If you're in Eugene or Portland, be sure to show up and check out the new video. Now, if you want to catch an exclusive first peek at the new video by Exile, there is a clip of it in this week's Fish Duck One-on-One video. I interviewed Exile and Jared Sawyer for it. We talked all about the video, and there is a special sneak preview of the music video within that footage. So if you want to get a special sneak peek at the new music video, click right here and you'll be able to check it out. As for fishduck.com, well, you know, everybody right now in the media is ramping up for football season, and so are we. We've had plenty of articles covering football, getting you prepared, what you need to know going into the 2012 season, particularly looking at defense. People have been asking us to cover Oregon's defense for some time now. In the last 2 weeks, Charles has gone roto-rooter on Nick Aliotti's defensive schemes. On Tuesday, we had another extensive video breaking down defensive schemes implemented by Nick Aliotti. So check out the video here. Click here if you want to find out all about Oregon's defense. And of course, our steady rotation of articles covering everything you need to know in duck sports. If you want to be kept up to speed on everything that's new on fishduck.com, go to the directory tab at the top of the website. Or alternately, you can sign up for our newsletter and we will send you a weekly update covering all the new videos and articles. And now, my random tweet of the week.
Hey, will you shut up?
Thank you.
Music recommendation time. Well, with the Olympics in full swing, I know everybody's glued to the TV watching badminton or fencing or archery or whatever other sport we only care about every 4 years, all in the name of nationalistic pride. But there's something else taking place this weekend that is definitely worth your time. The Newport Folk Festival. The long-running Newport Folk Festival has quite a place in history, most famous for being the place where Bob Dylan first went electric. Also, Led Zeppelin played one of their first ever concerts there in 1969, and every year it features great artists, legendary performances, and a variety of musical genres, not just folk music. This year they're doing a tribute to Woody Guthrie on the 100th anniversary of his birth. And NPR is on location doing live video streams and archiving audio of all of the performances on their website. So check that out. It's tremendous. It's free. Since Friday, I've been watching the Olympics on TV while simultaneously listening and watching to Newport Folk Festival on my computer. Already I've watched sets from Wilco, Alabama Shakes, Blitz and Trapper, Sharon Van Etten, My Morning Jacket, and others. And the festival continues through Sunday evening. So, if you're watching this, head to npr.org and click on the Music tab to find the link to live stream the video for all the great live music coming courtesy of NPR free of charge. Sunday's sets you can catch for free include Trampled by Turtles, Charles Bradley, Gary Clark Jr., Connor Oberst, he's better known as Bright Eyes, and Jackson Browne is closing out the festival. So while you're watching the Olympics on TV, grab your laptop and make the Newport Folk Festival your soundtrack for the Olympics. That does it for me this week. It was my birthday a few days ago. I'm officially old. Just remember, it's not the years, it's the mileage. Until next time, this is Kurt saying go fish, get hooked, go Ducks.